Over in the Visayas, operations are back to normal at the Mactan Cebu International Airport after Sunday's system glitch. Let's get the latest there from Annie Perez. Annie, over to you and Happy New Year.
Yes, Carmina, Happy New Year. Here in the Mactan Cebu International Airport, they have announced that they have returned to normal operations after certain technical issues which forced all trips to be cancelled yesterday. We talked to MCIAA, Aviation Authority spokesperson Mary Ann Dimabayo, who said that all flights resumed as of 5 a.m. this morning. They said that since the power issue is in slowly returning to normal, so as the operations also in the airport. She also reiterates that even if operations has returned, some flights that were originally scheduled for the day have been affected. They have noted some 18 flights that are still canceled today as they continue to cope up from the problem that happened yesterday. They also said that MCIA has remained open, including its runway, but they are advising their passengers to continue to monitor their airlines for coordination in the event that some flights will still be canceled today. Yesterday, they logged over 100 flights that were canceled, bound and inbound and outbound Cebu for both international and domestic. They also recorded some 5 flights going to Singapore and other international destinations that have asked to reschedule because of the incident that happened yesterday. And that's the latest here from Cebu. Anita Arias, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie. Take care. Moving on with the rest of the news, the Philippine Airlines, meanwhile, says it is back to regular flight operations. But the company admits some flights are still delayed, ranging from 30 minutes to 2 hours. The Philippine flag carrier sees Sunday's technical oversight as a temporary setback and hopes to return to normalcy within 72 hours.
The reason for these flight delays is because we are starting our recovery operations also today. When you say recovery operations, these are the flights which were stranded yesterday. These are the aircraft and its passengers stranded yesterday in different outstations, both international and domestic, and have just begun the process of returning to our Manila hub. So these airplanes were already earmarked for today's flights. This is a force majeure situation. It is not the fault of the air carrier.
Around 3,000 overseas Filipino workers are affected by the New Year's Day air travel masse. Migrant Workers Undersecretary says these workers have been assisted by the Philippine government with food and hotel accommodations. The official adds airline companies have helped rebook their flights.
We were directed by Secretary Toots Oble to be on the ground yesterday. Myself and OA Administrator Arnel Ignacio were on the ground to assist our OFWs whose flights had been affected by the flight cancellations. 1348 is the Department of Migrant Workers and OA hotline. Okay. For those needing assistance. And of course, there are Department of Migrant Workers and OWA counters at the airport, which basically happened also last night.
And let's head on over now to Davao, where over 2,000 passengers have been affected by flight disruptions. Our correspondent, Ernel Tokmo, now on the line with an update. Ernel, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, at least 2,600 passengers were affected by flight cancellations, diversions, and delays at Davao Francisco Bangkok International Airport here in Davao City on Sunday. This was due to the technical problems in the air traffic management center at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Last night, tensions rose among passengers of an airline company due to alleged lack of system in rebooking of flights. Passengers wanted to rebook their flights immediately as they still have to resume their work after the New Year break. Many of them were also tired after waiting for hours at the airport and uncertain of their flight status. One of the affected passengers was Daniel De La Torre. He was in Davao to attend the wake of his late elder brother who died Wednesday. He was still grieving for his brother's death, and the flight dilemma he experienced yesterday added to his stress. He was supposed to fly back to Manila to resume work, but his flight was canceled. However, after expressing their concerns to the airline management, the smooth system of rebooking of flights was in place, and De La Torre was able to rebook a special flight today. We've just arrived here at Davao Airport. We've seen passengers outside waiting to rebook their canceled flight. And we've talked to one of the passengers, and he said he was able to rebook his flight, but he still has to wait for many days because he rebooked it on January 6th, and the airline company will also not shoulder the accommodation expenses while they are waiting for their scheduled flight. According to the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, Davao, 15 flights were canceled yesterday while two flights were diverted and two flights were delayed. Reporting here in Davao City, Arnold Tokmo, ABS-CBN News.